Yes, and welcome to Oakfield Farm, everybody. This is episode number 2 in our career save. We're on hard mode, something a little bit different. If you haven't checked out episode number 1, make sure you go and watch that first before you watch this one. Then you know what's going on. But anyway, here we are back on the farm, field number 13. And as you probably remember, we were harvesting this particular field, and I am standing on top of the combine harvester, somehow managing not to fall in there. It doesn't look all that inviting down there, to be fair, although there are some stairs, so yeah, bag's not doing that. But anyway, we just need to finish off harvesting this field, and then we can take a look at some other jobs to do. But it's actually taken quite a while to harvest this field. It's quite a big job, actually. Let's bring the pipe in. But as this is chugging away, we'll have a bit of a chat about what we're up to. But yeah, it's taken probably about an hour and a half off screen to actually get this field to this stage here. It's a massive field. But it's and the yield hasn't been amazing. I'm still in two minds. I haven't done any research, and I should have, on whether the yields are reduced as well as the price of crops, etc., when you go ahead and sell them. So I'm not 100% sure on that. By now, someone's probably put something in the comments, but like I said last time, I'm going to be 4 or 5, or maybe 3 or 4 episodes ahead, just to try to ensure that I can put out consistent recordings. But here we are, just finishing off field number 13. We went ahead and we sold our very first load of wheat up at one of the selling points. It was only a small amount, it was only 8,000 litres, and we only managed to get just over $3,000 of income, which isn't a lot at all. Prices are definitely affected by the hard mode on this particular game, so that's something to that I'm going to have to really work on. But I've just been doing a bit of thinking, and one thing I did say at the last during the last episode was that I want to do as much manual work myself as I can, as opposed to hiring workers, because at this point of the save, money is really important. So, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. The next thing to do, though, is we've got one more field that needs to be harvested, and that's got barley. And so what I'm probably going to do is I'll probably go up and do the just get the headlands harvested, and then I'll set the worker away, and while they're harvesting our barley, I'll come down here with the baler, and I'll bale up all this chaff that's sitting around so we create some hay bales. And I'm happy to spend some money on a worker to do that, because basically if there's only one job to do at any time, then I'll do it myself. If there's multiple jobs that need to be done, then that's where I'll bring a worker into play. So what we'll do here, guys, is we'll just zoom over here and unload the small amount of wheat that's remaining. We will get there eventually. I should probably turn the go, that helps. I'm going super slow because I had the header on. There we go, there. We'll fold that away, and we will fold up the harvester, and we'll turn it off. Let's jump out and transfer over into the good old tractor here, which has 12,931 litres of wheat. So while I sold, let's get in cab. Look at this beautiful view here. Beautiful view. It's a very well modelled map. I'm going back out again. Why not? We sold our first 8,000 litres of hay of wheat, as I said before. But what we're going to do is we're going to actually store the rest down at the farm here, and just wait for either number one, a better price, or number two, if we really need some income to buy some implements or something like that, which I'm sure we're going to need to do pretty soon. It'll probably run up and sell some up at the tipping point. I need to have a think about the different implements and that sort of stuff that I have also at the moment. What am I doing here? Because it might be worth actually selling some of the stuff that you spawn with, and perhaps looking to swap it out with some different equipment. But we'll have a think about that soon. Okay. Okay. Let's go, and we're definitely going to need this pretty soon. So we're going to go and park this in a... Helps if I don't do that. Let's just park it over here in the meantime, out of the road. There we go. Turn that off. Remember to turn it off so you don't waste fuel. And let's grab our Let's turn on our good old combine harvester here. And we'll rip across here and we'll throw, if you remember from the last episode, I just hit my header trailer around the corner here on the field beside us. The very friendly neighbour allowed me to do it. Thank you very much. But what I'm going to do is come around here. Whoa. And hopefully that's sitting on there quite nicely. Now let's just take a quick look at our map. And as you can see up here, field number 34, that's got barley in it, and that's really where we want to go now. Now I'm not too sure where the entrance is. It probably looks like it's up here somewhere. So it's going to be a bit of a trip up there. So we might as well hook on our trailer here and start to make our way over the other side of the map. Now I won't show the entire trip, but I will show just a little bit of it, just so we start to get a bit of a feel for. There we go, look at that. I even look like an expert backer there for a couple of seconds. Let's not get too excited though. Stop getting carried away. Okay, so we'll just zoom out here a bit, just so we can see the length of this. Maybe I don't, because I think I'm gonna drag this through some of the trees by the looks of it. But here we go, and as we make our way down through the country road here, which is once again really well modeled, just a really nice touch. They've done such a good job here. And that's our farm, just sneaking through there. The chimney's on. I don't know why. It's the middle of summer. But anyway, there you go. I don't have seasons mod on this time, by the way. Just for something a bit different. Here goes our farm, our main farm right there. Let's get back with our eyes on the road. So I'll make our way over to the field, and I'll meet you guys over there in just 2 seconds. Okay, we are back. And as you can see down in the mini map, we are approaching field number 34. I'm just hoping that this is the way to actually get into the field. I probably should have done some research just to 100% make sure that's not it there. That's the entrance to field number 37 by the looks of it. That's a tiny little field, isn't it? But that's our field there, just to the right hand side, full of barley. Now all we need is a gate, and there it is, right there. Nice and easy, in fact. So what we're probably going to do is let's position this trailer somewhere out of the road. It was a bit hairy, to be honest. Oh, look, I'm around the wrong way, aren't I? It was pretty hairy actually coming up through on the road, particularly when other cars approach, because it's just this particular trailer. This particular vehicle, the combine harvester, does not leave a lot of. I hate backing these bloody things. Right, let's just go. I'm just going like this. I'm not right. Small movements is the key. Oh, nice. All right, cut things. I'll be back in a second. Okay, we are back and we are ready. And as you can see, just by some of that crop damage over there, there we go. It's not easy pointing. I had a bit of a tangle with that hedge right there, and I wrecked a few of the neighbour's crops, and wrecked his grass too, so probably not a good move on my behalf, but hopefully you won't notice. I'll just blame it on some of those bloody local kids in their cars. Now I've turned off my combine harvester. I'm on fire. You need to unfold the harvester, that helps. Alright, we're on fire today, guys. We are absolutely on fire. And so will this harvester be in a minute if I'm left to look after it. But what we're going to do, let's get in here. We've got some barley. And so, just taking a look at how much room. I'm probably going to have to do a couple of rounds here, just to provide enough room for the worker to be able to turn around. So what I'll do is, let's see how we're looking for time. Probably time is ticking on, so I'll cut to the next scene once we're ready to harvest the when we're ready to set the worker away. So I'll catch you very soon. Alright everybody, we are back and we have just about finished harvesting these headlands right here, and as you can see up on the left, I've grabbed my tipper and I've actually thrown the Fendt Vario on the front of it, the Fendt Vario 700, because I'm going to use my other, start the engine first. What am I doing? I'm actually going to use my other tractor for the baling, just a bit more grunt. And so what we'll do is we'll just tip the rest of this barley into the tip. I've already got one load in there of about 8,200 there or thereabouts. And there's another couple of thousand-ish. So what we're going to do now is we're going to set our work away. But I'm picking that he's not going to follow the path that I've just set because of the way that the fields were designed. But let's throw him out there and let's see what happens. What would I know? Okay, it's not going to be quite lined up. That's completely fine. We'll leave a little bit down the end, but he is away. So let's get back into our Fendt 700 Vario. It helps if I turn it on. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go and test to see whether I can tip this out at Oakfield Glen Barn and whether that will count towards my overall total of grain. I'm not sure if I can do it. I should once again research it, but trial and error, let's go ahead and do it. So it's not too much of a trip, so how about we enjoy some of the scenery? Hopefully we don't get too much lag coming through here. As you can see with the yellow grass down the side there, I've already managed to go off the road a number of times here driving around. But yeah, it's beautifully put together, the countryside here. Another big field of either wheat or barley right there. Helps if I keep my eyes on the road. Castle in the background. And here we go here. Now I think there's a tipping point. We'll quickly go and see what the story is. If this doesn't work, no problem at all. It just means it's going to be either a long trip back to my farm to store it, or I just go ahead and sell it somewhere closer. So I'm pretty sure it's up around here, the tipping point. Just there's probably a better way to go than this, I would imagine. This is a cool looking little yard, that's for sure. Here we go. Now I just don't know whether it doesn't look very promising, does it? I don't even know if that is a tipping point, in fact. Let's just line this up. I'm not confident at all. Oh well, dollars aren't going up, but barley is. Okay, great. This is a tipping point for a secondary tipping point for crop storage. So that is absolutely brilliant. Very happy with that. I'm just going to leave that guy there. And let's get into this little boy. I'm not too sure why I called a little boy. Ridiculous naming convention right there. Considering it's a bit bigger than the other one. But what we're going to do is we're going to go and grab our baler. And I'll go and do that. And then I'll meet you up at the field. Okay, welcome to field number 13. And I didn't really probably need that extra grunt. It's not the biggest baler you've ever seen. But let's unfold the baler right here. Let's lower the pickup and turn it on. And what should happen here is we should see... Let me just zoom out a little bit there. We should see the baler fill up. Oh, look, this thing pulls it so easily. If you see down the bottom right-hand corner, you can see the baler being filled up. And what should happen... I think this is a manual baler. We're at the beeping, as you can hear, it's getting close, and it should then prompt me. Yeah, this is a bit of a pain to be fair, but you've got to unload it manually like that. And then, oh, look at those are tiny little bales, aren't they? Close the back. Carry on. How much was that? Was that 2,000 or was it 4,000? I think it was only 2,000. These are just 2,000 litre bales. These are little bales. But hey, it's easy to pull around, and at the moment, beggars can't be choosers. I don't really have... Oh no, it is 4,000 bales. No, they're not little bales at all. They're completely fine. Great! Okay. I should really pay more attention to that beeping, shouldn't I? It's definitely a bit of a slow process compared to the auto unload, but hey, considering how quickly the... how quickly you can travel around on these fields with this baler. Shouldn't take too long to get around this entire field. Right, I'm paying attention to the beeping this time. So we'll wait for it to fill up, then I back a bit, then I unload it. And there we go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's a very good time to stop episode number 2. I hope you did enjoy it. Make sure you smash a like button, which is down here somewhere. Make sure you do it. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. It costs nothing at all except a little bit of self-respect when you have to admit that you're not a farm simulator channel. But hey, who's not willing to give up a bit of that? But hey, Episode 3 won't be too far away. I want to say a huge thanks for watching. And as always, till next time, take it easy.